I suppose it would help if you could actually hear us when we're talking. Welcome to Mobile Frame Zero Firebrands, presented by me, AP Gaming Reel. I am joined by this wonderful Kuru. We're going to go ahead and introduce ourselves and then jump directly into the game. As a quick description, I just want to throw out there, Mobile Frame Zero is mecha anime done Mario Party style in a tabletop RPG format. If you want to follow along with the rules, it's in the description on the YouTube VOD, or you can find it in chat right now. Virgil, let's start with you. We're gonna go counterclockwise from you. We're gonna start with the person I played with the most.
That's right. My contract has not expired, although I haven't shown up on the channel recently. Glad to be back to rock some mechs. Will we be in outer space or on the planet or
Both.
both?
We're gonna be everywhere.
Good. Because I've been curious what happens if you detonate a nuclear device in space because there's no oxygen. So maybe we could find out today.
Not much. The energy dissipates in every direction.
Interesting.
It hides in the power of RT.
Engineer a solution to
Yeah, we could probably look it up on the internet. Yeah, I'm excited because I just found out with everybody what this game is about. I've been really not able to put the time to learn it yet, so I'm gonna be flying by the seat of my mech's pants. Which I assume are like have like red and gold stripes and can deflect huge missiles
We'll
and
find
lasers.
out. There is a mech
Like
that starts
really
with a
awesome like
heraldic
hockey
color
pants?
scheme. Yeah.
Yeah.
Or is it just like like
Yeah, my mech can
a
even do
boxer
that
brief kind of
sick
thing,
like
right?
sideways like lower leg maneuver to block
Nice.
missiles from people behind me. Yeah, it's dope.
Nice. We'll get into that.
So
It's
you're
important.
basically Master Chief now.
Virgil is
Got
very
it.
quiet still. I'm fixing it. Fixing it. Thank
Yeah,
you.
you were super quiet. All right, Michael, why don't you introduce yourself?
Hello. I am Michael. I occasionally play games with AP on his channel and on other channels. You should watch us because we always get into fights and it's pretty great.
None of what you just said is great. I'll
Let's
fight you on that point.
roll together. Exactly. We're the best of friends. Anyway, I run Swift Kite Design. We're a game design collective. We're currently doing playtesting for The Circle, which is a really weird game about shamans, and you should check it out when I tell you all more about it because I haven't told you anything yet.
All right, cool. Kelsa, who are you?
Hello, I'm Kelsa. You can find me on the internet at Kelsa. I play in games. I play in this week. I am in seven tabletop RPGs that are being streamed.
That's a reasonable number.
Wow.
Oh, I'm
Crushing
sorry. You introduced yourself as Kelsa, not Eric Vulgaris. Sorry, I got confused.
it. We're pretty much the same person these days, except I have a job. I don't
Wow.
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 And
I
laser
assume
fire.
Eric is going to watch this VOD at
Missiles
some point,
launched.
so fucking
For
shots
sure.
fired.
Apply
Free
water to burned area.
Get wrecked, Eric. Allie, this is your first time on this stream. How are you, and who are you?
Am well, and I am Kelsa's fiance. I normally play roller derby or I roller skate at skate parks, but I'm here role playing with you guys tonight. And next week, tune into Kelsa's channel when she'll be dropping into a skate park bowl and quad skates for the first time.
What?
You know, it sounds like maybe that might not be a thing.
Yo,
Or not.
Patreon goals, right?
Let's see. Maybe I will go to a skate park and have roller skates on my feet, but I think that's as close as it's getting.
Also, if you try and do that, I will get my roller blades and do it in solidarity, I promise. I promise. I've got them right here.
All right.
Not as cool though.
They all really aren't, I'm gonna be honest.
It's time to start play. I'm gonna describe the system, and then there's no real GM. I'll be facilitating, although Kelsa will probably facilitate harder since she's actually played.
You can't shout.
Mobile Frame Zero. The year is SC0245.
Humanity has spread through the Milky Way, using the transit gate technology to colonize the galaxy. Ulbir Frames are the hard-working, hard-fighting combat and labor mecha that they have brought with them. You are a romantic ace mobile frame pilot, caught up in an undeclared war for the future of the Bantraw system.
Mobile Frame Zero Firebrands is a casual, and let's be clear, it's super casual, role-playing game by D. Vincent Baker, set in the Mobile Frame Zero universe. To play, you need 3 to 5 players, a copy of this rulebook for everybody, and a handful of coins. And possibly a bad Japanese accent when you want to say cool stuff.
Not a problem. I'm just going to do a bad dub accent.
Excellent. The object of this game is to create messy entanglements. Fall in love with your enemies, ally with your rivals, and fight with your friends. When to start the game, we introduce our characters. Each of us will take turns creating a character by choosing a faction, attractive qualities, and a name. Kelsa, any chance you'd like to go first as our resident mobile frame expert?
Sure. Point of note, it might help if you give us some notes.
Yeah. Yeah, I will give you all handouts.
And we can use that, just have everybody be able to view and and write on them, but we should each have one for ourselves. So we can just jot down character stuff.
Just pick one on the character thing and just rename it to your own.
Okay, cool. So I'm gonna pick a faction. Last time I played, I was from the landowner faction, which are basically the three factions, because this is kind of important, are the people who live on Bantraw, who are broken up into two groups, the Bantresh, which are the nobility, and the rebels, who are not. And then the landowners, who are from outer...
For the term revolutionaries?
Well, I know where Virgil's going to.
Oh, I see how it's going to be. Okay. The revolutionaries. The third faction being the landowners, who technically own the planet, but they really haven't done anything with it in about 300 years. And so the people who actually live there think that they should profit. I don't want to be a landowner this time, so I think I'm going to be nobility, the Bantresh. I'll read the little faction blurb. The Bantresh are the aristocratic families of Bantraw. You are a hereditary warrior prince or princess of a noble family. Mobile Frame Ace Pilot and the off-world landowners have robbed you of your wealth. You've been raised to believe that the wealth of Bantraw belongs to the Bantresh. The Bantresh of the same family are your friends. The Bantresh of different families are your rivals. The landowners and revolutionaries are your enemies. Choose three attractive qualities, a name, a family name, describe your mobile frame.
Well, last time, I happen to know you picked some pretty scary qualities.
I did.
That can be attractive.
Can be.
I mean, it was attractive to someone for sure. You were like the belle of the ball.
I know. Oh, did you have tentacles growing out of your face or something?
What? No. Yeah,
I did. I think I am going to be fiery, radiant, and rich. Because that's good.
That's a good one, too. Yeah.
My name is going to be Bella. A Latin family name is Roche. Mobile frames are the walking combat and labor mecha that the humanity has brought with them to colonize the galaxy. Frame is a military model, probably a chub, custom built for personal, armed with armor and grand dial, kitted out in heraldic insignia and the colors of your house. So her combat mech has the heraldry of the Roche House, the unicorn, and so her mech, of course, actually looks like a unicorn.
Yeah.
It has four legs, yep. And it has huge, like, laser saber out of its face.
I believe, having read the lore, it's called a plasma cutter.
I'm sorry. You're right, plasma cutter.
We can't infringe upon Disney.
Right.
They will stomp the shit out of us.
Right, laser cutter. Plasma, whatever. Point is, huge glowing horn that'll fuck your shit up.
Yeah, does sound pretty bad. Kelsa, I don't know if there's any way to boost your mic volume, but it seems like everybody's coming in low tonight.
When I do this, do you
hear? Oh god, that's so much louder.
Are these qualities from a list?
Yes, yes. Open up your copy of the game.
The 32 page.
Yes.
There is also a list of qualities. If you look on pages 5, 6, and 7, you should be able to find exactly what we're looking at for the different three factions.
So we have one person with the band Tresh faction. Anyone want to go next in choosing their faction type?
Well, I'm a fucking landowner, man.
All right, landowner, eh? Well, tell us what landowners are.
Landowners, according to Solar Union law, the right shareholders of the wealth of Bantrol. I'm a mobile flame ace pilot employed to defend and secure my employer's rights. I'm basically a paramilitary person, which is kind of cool. Landowners and their soldiers and their officers are my friends. Bantrest are my rivals. When the fight breaks out, they're my enemies. The revolutionaries are my enemies. Full stop. Choose three attractive qualities. I'm going to go with friendly, good-hearted, and conflicted. Because I'm a soldier that's been sent here to subjugate a people group. So that seems obvious. My name is Asami Iwata. She's like a Japanese girl with a pixie cut. My company I work for is Shogunate Multistellar, wearing the Japanese influence on my sleeve. My unit designation is I'm a member of the Yonkai, and my call sign and the name of my mobile frame is the Raven, and it's a stealth deployment mech.
Okay. So it's got,
yeah, it's badass. I'm excited.
Allie, Virgil? We got any revolutionaries in here to balance us out?
I am definitely going to go for the revolutionary.
Can you bump your sound real quick? I know you said you were going to. It dropped again. # Windows. We got sound problems for days, guys. Sound problems for days. Welcome to One Shots.
It wouldn't be streaming if there weren't sound problems.
I know.
Plus 30 decibel boost.
That sounds good.
Volume all the way up to 100.
That's much better.
It instantly goes back to 95.
I mean, you're doing good right there.
Yeah.
I'm just going to keep that open.
Cry your tears.
Okay, let's get back to this thing where the things of the choosing.
So, Revolutionary is on page 7, if you hadn't already
chosen. Here we go.
Tell me about yourself, Revolutionary.
Well, the undeclared war between the landowners and the Bantresh is an opportunity for the people of Bantrel to rise up. You are a revolutionary captain, a mobile frame ace pilot, fighting for your freedom from both hereditary tyranny and off-world rule. It's your opinion that the wealth of Bantrel should belong to its people.
Etc. I have some qualities to pick.
True.
I think I'm dashing. I mean, I don't even know what they mean by that, really.
Just pick three things.
Sure,
that sound
dashing,
cool.
Funny and inspiring.
I mean, I knew you were going to pick funny. It's you. It's you.
So you're like the SCV driver from StarCraft, right? Mm-hmm.
How do I get out of this chicken shit outfit?
No, butter my biscuit.
Precisely.
My name is Ichiro. It's not pronounced Ichiro. It's pronounced Ichiro. Incorrectly.
The worst. All right.
Because this is a bad dub.
Yeah. I mean, my character was sliced in from a bad dub of the original series. Because they had removed him at first because some of his humor was a little bit off, mm-hmm. off color. Let's see. Profession of my daily life. I am
moisture like farmer.
No. I am hired by moisture farmers to like protect their dry air from being stolen.
Okay.
Yeah. No, I say that I'm when the revolutionaries have like an area, I like patrol it to try to keep our like bases safe.
Oh, so your day job is literally like you work for the revolution full time.
Yeah, and I just like
you're hardcore. You're not like one of those nighttime weekend warriors.
Mm-mm. No, I like parade around all day like being revolutionary in everything I do.
Like how open are you?
Revolutionizing like just going to the bathroom or eating a sandwich, like whatever.
You always like preaching the good news of the revolution and all that fun stuff?
Yeah. Yeah.
Awesome.
Like, yeah, we only lost 30 soldiers in our fight last night, and we also lost 20 kilometers, but it's fine. Go revolution.
Sounds so American right now.
Oh, I'm gonna die. This is great.
Allie, you have a character you want to tell us about?
You all stole my ideas, all three of you.
Oh, shit.
I'm joking.
You want to play mine?
No, I want to play Virgil's. I'm going to be also a revolutionary. The gutter snipe class, the one that doesn't really own anything. Am I on the right track here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, yeah, I'm going to play a character. Oh, let's name her in the undeclared war between landowners and the Bantarash, there's an opportunity for, yeah, all that stuff that he read earlier about the revolutionaries. But while both of them are my enemies in principle, some are more sympathetic, blah, 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 I get to choose three attractive qualities for Ruby. Let's see. Which ones were already taken? I don't want to duplicate you too much.
Did you save a note, Virgil?
Yeah, hold on. It was dashing, funny, and inspiring.
Right.
This guy.
Okay.
You were just playing Virgil.
So I was going to be dashing, but instead I'll just be charming. I was going to be funny, but instead I'll be resolute and inspiring. So what am I? I'm charming, resolute, and inspiring. And I use my inspiring resolute charm to basically keep alive. I'm an opportunist for a living. I like to make people who don't like me fight each other, and then I loot the remnants.
I feel like you're the one that's going to come out on top of this so far.
Oh, don't worry. A challenger approaches.
Oh, shit.
Oh, fun.
Have we talked about your mobile frame? I feel like what's going to happen is I'm going to introduce my character, and then we're going to go around and maybe get a little bit more specific about our frames. Do you have any thoughts about what yours looks like?
Yeah, mine, so Ruby, it's small red, kind of unobtrusive. It's got very simple weaponry. It's got the to entry-level base model cloaking field. So it's low-key as far as that goes, but it has a illusionary field, holographic field that can cause it to appear like other Macs.
Mirror image.
Yes. So are you like one of the few people in the revolution that has like a proper mech?
Mine is like five or six mechs that we've cobbled together.
Yeah, no, that sounds about right.
It's like you've like soldered all of them together and you somehow managed to like swindle your way into a good mech.
Yeah.
Is that what happens?
That's exactly what happened.
I like it.
Ruby and then revolutionary.
It's time to introduce my character. I'm going to start with a short description of what he looks like. Imagine, if you will, a 6'1", kind of vaguely tanned man of Caucasian descent with this glorious blonde hair pushed back, except for like two strands in the front that come down like that. His hair is always waving like there's a gentle breeze going past. Even in space.
Right.
You have like small actuators in the skull implanted.
Of course.
So just wave your hand.
Just micro fans.
And instead of brown eyes, he has light yellow eyes. His name is Maximus Valentine. And he is from the landowner faction. He is a major who has his own contractor company called the Solar Angels. He is fashionable, confident, and striking. And he pilots a modified Osprey V2 using a new system called the Quadro Engine Linked System. The KELS, which are four engine blocks mounted on the back of this thing, so it goes way faster than it should. And so this mech, it's very like base Gundam-y, except the headpiece has like two really tall antennas. The shoulder pads become wings because there's no maneuverability on the back because all four engines are there. It becomes very hard to turn. It has a plasma cutter under each hand, and it's got all sorts of spots to attach rocket launchers to. So you just like fire the rockers once, and then they pop off. There's no reloading. You just fire a shit ton of missiles, and then they all fall off, and you can maneuver better. And his mobile frame is called Devil. Perfect. His call sign is Cheesecake because he's so rich and white. His call sign right there. Perfect.
And I died inside. Thank you, AP.
All right. Yeah. I don't know if anybody else has had as much thought about mobile frames.
Well, I've been thinking about it.
If you want to go into a little bit more description before we get it started playing solitaire.
I didn't describe Bella at all. So I think I'm going to take an opportunity right now to do that.
Yeah.
She is kind of tall and a little bit wiry. And when she's not in a noble suit, you're always going to see her in like the height of fashion. She has long dark hair and like that perfect complexion where you just cannot pin down any kind of heritage at all. Just slightly darker than white, but much lighter than, you know, just right there in the middle.
Have you seen Gallivant?
Yes.
Isabella?
Yes.
Okay.
Secrets.
Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Michael, you look like you're eager.
You know what I just typed in chat? I was had like multiple things open. Sorry.
Yeah, it's true. Fine.
Yeah, I'll go. My character whose name did not appear when I edited my mysterious note. Because it appears that AP edited over my mysterious note.
Oh, shit. My bad. Also, get wrecked at the same time. I want to apologize and take credit.
We'll apologize. That sounds like the AP I know. Anyway, But Isami is Japanese origin. She kind of like she's got like she's like tall, but she's got like a bright like dark blue pixie cut that she wears with pride because it's the future and she can be awesome like that because we're in an anime. Or just awesome in real life, I don't really know. Anyway, but her mech, the Raven, is like I said, a stealth model, and it's like really like thin and kind of wiry and jet black, except for like the silver like stencil of a raven with like a ribbon in its mouth, like on like the back shoulder pad of the mech, and that's like basically it. It's got like a badass katana or something. I don't know. We'll make it up. It'll be fine.
All right. Ichiru has like a black bowl cut.
Yeah, of course.
Thick dark eyebrows that kind of wedge just a little bit outwards. And his face can't do anything but smile. It's a little off-putting. He's just like very low the amount of frames for this guy. He's short, and he wears like these like green like cloth gloves that are cut off the fingers, and he thinks that's cool.
You wear fingerless gloves. Mm-hmm. Okay, just wanted to be clear.
Yeah, and this isn't like cool in the like time frame we're playing in either.
Watching too much Naruto.
My mech. Is like cobbled together. The main body of it is like kind of too big for everything else, but it has like huge artillery on the back of it. The legs, like we were describing, are like huge flat surfaces, but they can actually like come out and like dig into the ground. I'd shelter from artillery while I can shell from like the huge back of my thing. And the arms are both from different machines as well. One of them has like a giant blade. The other one has like a bunch of just ammunition, like huge rounds of ammunition, and then can open up to fire a set of like 20 missiles.
Oh, like heavy arms. Yeah.
And then the head is like looks like similar to if you dropped a cinder block on like a knight's helmet and then
instead of eyes it's just open like boop boop, boop.
Just like yeah, a little crushed pieces.
Perfect.
It's tack welded on there. We'll put the TIG welder to it later.
Yeah, when you have time, when you aren't revolutionizing. Yeah.
It's one of those where it's held together with rubber bands and like paper clips that have been bent into the mesh shape.
It's because our engineers are just revolutionary.
Perfect. Guys, I'm so excited.
Anybody else have anything they want to describe about their character or their mobile frame?
No.
Okay. On pages 9, 10, and 11, find the solitaire game for your specific faction, and then just run through it real quick by yourself. You'll find your pick events. Based on everything that happens to you during this time, something will happen, and next time you meet someone, there might be something they notice or something they might have heard about you. So, you know, if some major things happen, you'll let us know. At any time when we are playing a game, if you get bored, if you just aren't participating, you can always play solitaire by yourself and establish something the next time you meet. Like, this happened to me while you were busy playing skirmish.
Alright, so we're just picking one of these?
Yep. Anyone? Yeah, you pick the one that deals with your faction, so revolutionaries in the middle. And then you pick answers from each of the questions.
Well, not each of them, just one.
Okay. Just doing one.
Are we doing this by ourselves, or we can actually do a mini scene about them? When I played with Eric, we wound up just describing the mini scene as far as the opening, which turn out pretty cool, but it's not necessary.
I was thinking we would cut into play and then like jump back when we do the description, like
Sure. You just tell us how you want to do that.
Yeah. So just make sure you run through it real quick. Kelsa, again, hate to keep jumping towards you, but any chance you'd like to play the first game?
Sure.
If you're done solitaring.
I'm done solitaring.
So you pick which minigame you want to play and who your partner is.
Okay.
And then we'll read the rules.
Let me double check what all of our games are. Okay. I think definitely one of the revolutionaries is my partner here. First of all, Michael, can you change your display name in
to your pilot name?
Pilot name.
Oh yes, that is a thing I can do. I apologize.
So these mini games are like a dance and like
This is the whole game is playing
They're
mini games.
They're amazing.
Don't worry, Virgil. We'll get into it.
Yeah, I just haven't really looked at this.
Okay, I think I kind of wanted to be Virgil actually, and make it a chase.
Oh, this is a good start.
I know. I think it's a really good start because Virgil's is the revolutionary.
So I probably need to get to that.
So it's on page 14 for everyone following along.
The revolutionary.
Play, choose which of you is the hunter and which is the quarry. Ask your partner how the chase came about.
So you get to set the stage, Virgil.
Wait. Where is this? 13, 14. Okay, set up.
So okay, and which of we decide together how this chase came about. We decide together who is chasing who. Do you think that you are chasing me or that I am chasing you?
I'd probably be chasing you.
That was kind of what I was feeling as well.
Yeah.
That I'm the quarry and you are the hunter.
Yeah.
So.
And I'm trying to take you out before you can get back to base and report anything that you might have seen.
Yeah. So how did we come about? Like you saying report anything I might have seen. So was I
You were too close to the area I'm patrolling.
Okay. So this is like I got close to finding a revolutionary hideout. Like, is this in a city?
This is like a small out. It's like a smaller outlying suburb. Where like my people send me out every once in a while if there's anything caught on radar.
All right.
So yeah, as soon as you got too close.
What do we notice about each other? What have you heard? This is where what you just did in solitaire comes into effect. So for example, what you heard after my solitaire game is that the soldiers in House Roach are more concerned about fashion than about mech fighting. And probably this applies to this tiny mech that looks like a fucking unicorn. So take that how you will.
Okay. Yeah, I take that as being a bit silly. Who are you going? Okay, so where are you going then?
So you also take a look at what you.
Oh, my thing. Okay, so just read both of them to you.
So just tell me what I heard.
Oh, I'm just misunderstanding that a tiny bit. I thought both of them were for me. It's the answer that I chose for you.
So yeah, you don't have to read me the direct answer. You can read me the.
Okay.
Because of that answer, what?
Right. Because of that. Because of what happened to me. You recognize my mech as someone that was like disabled but then escaped.
Okay, so this is something that had we had seen seen you, and you've been
disabled. Like I had a previous mech that was disabled, but I escaped.
Okay.
And get captured.
Cool. Okay. During the chase, anyone can ask questions for details about the landscape, what's ahead, what's behind, and what the course the hunt might take.
So, my immediate question is, where does this take place?
So it is on, like, the outskirts of, like, a major city. And I'm picturing it be, like, right on the edge of the wilderness. Like, maybe there's some abandoned warehouses or rarely used warehouses or something that I was checking out near... near this suburb. And so it's like going to be partially suburban, partially wilderness. As the quarry, I conduct the chase. First, I say where I'm going. I'm going back to my manor house. I'm going back to the Roche Estates. Lead the hunter through a series of four challenges and admissions. Choose freely, except the third one must be an admission. During the chase, you and the hunter gain coins representing the distance you're able to gain on each other. We're definitely in our mobile frames.
I mean, it says decide with your partner. How about your partner? Okay, there we go.
I mean,
mobile
I feel
frame
like we're definitely
fire.
In our mobile frames.
Because the mobile frame I'm in is like, they were like, this guy is now piloting a new frame.
And I wouldn't have known that if you weren't in a frame.
So I'm curious, is this fight starting like you're both already at full power and running and or jetting away? Or is this the moment where you both see each other on sensors and you're scrambling for what to do?
She sees me like blasting toward her because I had already like... at base had been scrambled.
A challenger appears then.
Yeah. Like I get like a red blinking. I always have my augmented reality glasses on. So I get like a blinking alert and then like suit up, get in your damn mobile frame. We got incoming. I'd scramble to the janky ass garage that we keep our mechs in, and then blast out of the opening ceiling straight towards the quarry.
I'm curious, just for my own, does your mech have like space jet? Is it space worthy? Could it go into space using its blast jets, or is it all just like a running?
The center part of the bot is like the best part. It has like the biggest missiles and it has like huge space going stuff, but it's very questionable as to whether the like helmet where I reside inside of while piloting
could actually make it
the vacuum of space with its considerable damage.
It's literally just a mesh ball with a chair inside of it.
Can you check your volume real quick, Virgil? You're coming in super low again.
I'm so weirded out by this.
Mustache mech. I don't know about that one. Alright. Quarry, let us begin the chase. Shall we dance?
I lead a dizzying course through which black... Boy, I can talk, I swear. Lead a dizzying course through switchback and blind. Follow me if you want, but throw. On tails, you're lost and won't be able to find your own way back. So as I see you approaching, I immediately, my mech darts deeper into the city and dashes. It's surprisingly quiet for like an 8-ton mecha. It's barely larger than a car and it's on 4 legs. And it fishes down various streets, makes sharp turns and alleyways. If you follow me, you might get lost.
Alright, I'm gonna try to like keep altitude until I can like drop down in front of you.
All right.
To challenge you.
Okay.
So are we doing one is heads and two is tails?
Yes.
Yep. Alright.
Throw the bones.
Who rolls here?
You roll.
You
You're the hunter.
Oh, okay.
Throw those bones. Allow fate to decide. No!
Tails!
You lost. All right.
Yeah.
She disappears. I land on,
I just like land on a rooftop and like boards and dirt and dust and everything like flies up around my mech. I'm like scanning. All I have is like my readouts. It's just telling me I'm in a dust cloud.
Well, you're lost and you won't be able to find your way back.
Is that my outcome?
Yep. All right, Quarry, what's step two?
Restarting your GPS.
So we move on to the next. I do another challenge here. I scramble up a steep incline. Follow me if you can keep up on, but throw on a tail. The way is exhausting, and I gain a coin. So, you catch sight of me again, and you see that I've left the suburban area, and I'm now like going through the woods. I'm like, there's like a steep cliff face that my nimble four-legged mech is climbing up, and if you can follow me up it, you can try, but it might mean that your jets are out of gas or...
Yeah, so when I catch sight of you, I give a blast on my jets and they start spurting because I've been like hovering so long looking for you.
Did you burn the house that you just landed on down?
Yeah, how worried are you about collateral damage in this case? I'm just curious.
Not at all, because the more collateral damage there is, we blame it all on them.
Oh, so it's just fuel for the
like. No matter what happens, it always seems like people blame them, and we just get more people on our side. It's great.
I like it.
So what I do is I drop down into like this funny looking run. But then I just reach down with my mech and like pull off the huge front plating on my legs and drop both platings to the side.
All right, good.
So I can try to scramble up this. Roll again?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
So bad at rolling.
All right, so I now have a coin, but now I have to have an admission. I have to give you coins.
Not necessarily.
I might give you two.
It can happen.
I steal a look back at you, and you're nearer than I thought. Throw on a heads, you put on a burst of speed.
What does this look like for you? You're like a magical unicorn mech galloping up the side of a hill, and he's just like, oh, blah, blah.
are you like a proper unicorn, or are you like a centaur?
No, I'm totally a proper unicorn.
Proper unicorn. Awesome.
Yeah.
Okay,
and
here
the unicorn,
goes.
The unicorn's head turns back and looks over its shoulder.
I'm imagining the horse robot from Animatrix right now.
In my mind, it's the robot unicorn from
Robot Unicorn Attack.
Yeah, totally.
Okay, so I'm gonna like open up my left arm where I have like all those missiles, and then I'm going to rocket jump on top of you.
Oh, you do it!
Mm-hmm.
Oh, dang. All right.
I just, like, launch 20 missiles underneath my feet. Up to the top of the slope.
All right. I reach, like, right as you get to the top, I reach clear ground and leap away. Follow me if you can rally yourself, but throw. On a tails, you stand gasping and I gain a coin. So you rocket jump up there, and just as you're about to do there, like a deer, I spring off across open ground, headed for the tree line.
Huh, she has twice as many legs as me. This isn't fair at all.
Yep. Two.
Totally not fair.
You stand gasping as you land, and I get a coin.
So you're at 2-2, right?
Yes. Unfortunately, that means that you catch me.
You get to pick an option.
If the hunter has as many coins as you...
I got two?
Yeah.
Yeah, you got two for succeeding on that one admission.
Yep. The first thing I did not give me a coin.
Okay.
Which I probably should have thought about. But
he could have just ended the chase if he didn't want to put himself in that fictional position, though.
It's true. But now you're lost in the woods, but... you on page 14, ending the chase, If the hunter has as many coins as you or more, choose one. Oh, I choose. Okay. Let's see.
Changing my outcome because it's more interesting.
Where's ending the chase is above both.
I think I've come to some temporary security. I'm wearing a tree to climb, a door I can lock behind me. Here's what I've gone to ground. So what you did not realize was this was actually very close to one of my holdings. I have a bat cave nearby, and my rainbow unicorn dashes behind a waterfall. And when you go to look behind the waterfall, there is no door. The solid rock face has now appeared, but I'm trapped in my little bat cave, my unicorn cave.
You could just wait her out.
That's our scene.
All right.
Cool. Anyone who wants to go next? Pick a game, pick a partner, and then let's roll.
I'll follow that up. Let's look at my options here. I want to juxtapose the awesome chase sequence with something far more mundane, and have like a conversation over dinner with someone. Who would I be meeting? Does anyone jump up to volunteer, or do I have to pick?
Well, technically, it's entirely your choice.
Yeah.
Entirely my choice. Okay. Oh,
Maximus Valentine.
Me and Maximus's character.
Major
Captain
Valentine.
Captain Maximus Valentine.
No, Major.
Me and
Major.
Maximus Valentine.
Sky Captain of the Sky. Wait, what was it?
Sky Captain Maximilian Valentine, Captain of the Sky.
Yeah.
I feel like this is a case where me and my unit were at like a spacer bar, and then your unit showed up and like sat down with us because we're kind of here doing the same thing.
Actually, I get to choose.
You get to choose.
Yep. All right. You've chosen your partner, and then I get to choose how we came together. And so I think that the planet Bantresh has a space elevator where they take solar energy from its pure form in space. Because, you know, Earth only has, or Bantresh, sorry, only has so much space you can put solar panels on, but space has infinite space to put solar panels on. So all of the solar energy is channeled down the space elevator, and that's how, like, ships and mechs all go up and down that don't have enough booster rockets.
You're explaining this to me as
No, I'm telling you where this is happening. There's a peace conference happening, being hosted by my faction, the Solar Union landowners, at a restaurant that's at the base of the space elevator. It's a French cuisine restaurant called the Hot Gaston. Would anybody, would any other players like to be there, since it is a peace conference? Any characters looking to stop the war might end up there, or agents looking to disrupt
that's
it.
Very opportunistic.
Yeah.
I'm not there, but I can say something that you've heard, right?
Yes.
Based off of the song or whatever. Okay. What's the noble faction called again?
The Bantresh.
Bantresh. Okay. You've heard that two Bantresh night guard mobile suit units were guarding a warehouse full of this fuel, and they mysteriously started fighting each other, and then one took off with the other's unit.
Oh snap!
It's awesome.
That's rough.
Awesome. Yeah.
Kelsa, Virgil, any chance you want to show up in character here?
I actually might want to run and use the bathroom real quick.
So. Okay, all right.
I'm gonna do that.
Mention my name. Get a good seat.
Oh, good.
All right. Cool.
I think I will stay out of this one.
All right. Well, then let's have a conversation. So
let's talk over drinks.
During the meal, anyone can ask for details about the setting, occasion, and circumstances. The person with the lowest standing takes the first turn. You've heard about me is that since I've arrived on this planet, I've spent a lot of time just palling around with friendly units like the regular planetary guard, revolutionaries, band trash. I just like wander around with my unit, stopping conflicts, and then just like standing at the edge of waterfalls and looking out majestically and getting selfies. Traveling in the countryside in a truck with like friendly guides from the local people, and I'm just basically touristing it up here while I'm busy stopping the war.
Well, you know that while you were off touristing, I was like in the shit, and me and my unit were on patrol, which is weird because we're like a stealth unit, but they had to put us there because they didn't have anyone else to send.
I mean, that's how war works, revolution.
Yeah, right? Like, we're, like, trained to do one thing, and then they tell us to do something else because they don't have anybody else.
Which faction are you from?
I'm also a landowner, but I work for a different corporation.
Oh, right. Cool. I'm glad you're here, then.
Maybe. Yeah.
We'll see.
You've got a rough
life so far.
I am totally... You also know that I am totally willing to put myself at risk to save civilians. Because I had my unit clear an area while I personally defused like a massive explosive device planted by rebels.
What is your rank?
I'm a lieutenant.
All right, so you are definitely my social inferior.
Mm-hmm.
You get to go first, and you have four options. It's on page 16. You can ask a topical question. Engage in improvised conversation, pass saying something about the food, or leave. If we both pass, the conversation ends.
Oh, I think, so, like, we get the scene of her being, like, up all night training, like, punching at, like, a punching bag. And it's, like, obviously, like, really early in the morning. And then it's, like, the smash cut to her, like, sitting at a dinner table, and then she just... I make a horrible, ignorant social blunder. Do you let me recover gracefully, or do you hold it against me?
Oh, Maximus Valentine, major of his unit, the Solar Angels, of course allows you. What is the blunder that you make?
I feel like it's something that wouldn't occur to like a normal soldier because I recently got promoted. It's probably something like how to respectfully eat. Like, I'm just, like, shoveling food.
And then as I swoosh my hair, the two strands in the front curl back into position, and my hair waves in the imaginary breeze, and Maximus Valentine's just like, "My dear, you can slow down and eat now. I know as a common soldier you must have tried to savor every meal, but you represent the Solar Union here. Some decorum would aid you. Here, this is how you hold the fork."
This beef sauvignon is
fantastic. Just, like,
I'm like ripping off a piece of bread right as he says that. Thank you, officer.
That's major. But we aren't in the same chain of command. Don't worry about it. And I will engage in actual improvised conversation as I put my elbows on the table and lean forward towards Usami, and I'm like, "So, what brings you specifically to Band Fresh?"
Girl's gotta work.
Just a job.
Yeah. Nothing else? I think I can do some good here.
Can do some good?
Yeah.
Curious. Yeah. What are your thoughts about peace?
Well, I think no one benefits from open warfare. Granted, if there's not peace, I'm out of a job. But that's reversed. Never mind. I'm sorry. I've been on patrol for like a long ass time. I want the war to end, but it would cost me money. How's that? Awkward anime smile, teardrop.
There's always something to do in the Solar Union. I wouldn't worry about it, Lieutenant. If it's not Bantresh, it's somewhere else. I feel like I've engaged. Make your choice.
I hope I can find common ground with you about our purpose here. Do we have common ground on why we're here? I'm here to get a job and, like, maybe shut down the war. What are you here for?
Maximus Valentine is here because he heard Bantresh is a fantastic planet to retire to, and that the women here are all exceptional. He is here looking for love and a nice retirement cottage. This, Lieutenant, will hopefully be my last deployment throughout the galaxy. I've made quite a bit of credit, and now credit is what's due me. Once the peace is brought to Bantresh, I believe I shall retire here. I saw a fantastic waterfall while I was hiking yesterday with my unit. The gravity there is just perfect for foosball. Just unbelievable.
Oh, you play?
I do. Do you?
I'm on occasions. It's pretty popular with the boys in my unit.
It is the national sport of the Solar Union, so unsurprising. The level of tactical skill mastery required is one that translates into any environment.
Is it future foosball where you actually put a bunch of mechs on a big rod and then someone spins them mechanically?
Of course, and each of the mechs is different, right? Yeah. To represent the different frames. So, you know,
it's
like,
also include for it's like a 3D element.
The goalie one is like a big blocky one, and the frontliners are all like thin, wiry ones. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It bears only the slightest resemblance to common day foosball.
It has evolved beyond its previous form.
I'm feeling expansive. What do you want to know about me? So as the courses are being changed out from the first to the second, Maximus Valentine leans back and is like, "So, Lieutenant, I'm sure you've heard about me. Many of the stories are true, but is there anything you need confirmed? Anything you want to ask?"
"Heard you're a ladies' man."
"That's true. I already mentioned that earlier in the conversation, actually."
"Yeah, I was wondering if you were bragging or not."
"I mean, is it truly bragging to speak about how wonderful you are?"
"Oh, honey.
Yes.
Just a bit. And trust me."
Like, does he have that smile with like the like bling?
"Yes, of course. I should mention he's also got glasses, by the way, just in case I need to do the glasses shine thing."
Swing.
He doesn't need them. Like, they're not prescription glasses. They're just so that he can do the
frame. Just to have it.
Yep. Oh. It's your turn. Oh, no. We're getting hit with glasses. Oh, no. I mean, if I hit my camera with glasses, you won't be able to see shit. Wow. That totally canceled out the light spectrum.
I think they pick up like a piece of like salmon or something like that, like really expensive imported earth fish. And they're just like, and she's just like, "God, this would have been so much better on rice." And just like puts it into her mouth.
"Ah, you like Japanese cuisine?"
"Yes. Yeah, I grew up there."
"Just because someone looks Japanese doesn't mean that they might like Japanese food, Lieutenant.
You are a progressive.
It's a large galaxy.
Check that." Mm-hmm. "All right.
I've often found it strange how the many Japanese cuisines nowadays believe that serving the vegetables and roots raw rather than cooking them like in this French cuisine is an acceptable manner. Two ways to get the same kind of flavor."
"One of the mysteries of the universe, I guess."
I am going to ask, "I hope to get you to commit to a joint sortie to end the revolutionaries. Lieutenant, my company could use a auxiliary unit attached. I'm hoping to launch a skirmish to end the revolutionary threat. I don't suppose you'd deign to join me in the field.
Well, Major, the Yonkai are scouts. We'd be good for forward operations, but if you're looking for frontline troops, we're not your team.
You disappoint me, Lieutenant. In the Solar Union, all troops are frontline troops.
No.
Every mech's a rifle mech, as they say.
Well, I do my talking with a sword. There.
Well, it sounds like you'll be doing your talking very quietly in a bush while the rest of us use our swords.
Fair enough.
Your turn.
I accidentally spill a secret that my unit is under strict orders not to engage with rebel forces. And I'm just like, yeah. Us is upstairs, wouldn't like it that either way, but, you know, they don't like us doing anything that they don't explicitly order. She, like, backpedals real fast. Do you, I cover it gracefully. Do you pick up on it anyway?
No. I've checked out of this conversation already. I've asked you for support, and you basically chickened out. I've got the measure of just who Usami is, and it's not positive.
Mm-hmm.
Valentine's like already like, check, please.
Yeah. At least the food's good.
I will spend my turn talking about the food in a pass, saying, this quail is fantastic. I hope I can get it to go.
Running away from me. But yeah, it is real good. Cut.
Are you also passing, leaving the
conversation? Yeah, I'm passing. I'm done. All right,
we're out.
Perfect. She's just like not about this guy.
I was just hoping to find love and also an ally against the dangerous revolutionary threat.
You had her until you told her to go into a battle that her team wasn't ready for.
All right. Who's next on the chopping block?
So, I don't know what game this would be quite yet, but cut to a scene of me playing foosball with someone and getting my butt kicked.
It is the national sport, I've heard.
The national sport. It's tactical. It requires all the stuff that I'm getting my butt kicked in a game of foosball here.
What scene would that be?
I mean, theoretically, that could be a solitaire scene. But if you want to actually have a something between two people.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're back at base and we're playing foosball, we could have an animated disagreement.
Or we're stealing time together. You would, although that would it like
feeling time together is very like lovery thing.
I know.
So we should have the animated disagreement first, and we'll have makeup sex later.
So my question is, which one of you is challenging the other to an animated disagreement?
Which page is animated disagreement on?
12.
Page in it.
12.
12.
And it is between.
Me and
Ruby and Ichiru. Yeah.
Ichiru. Okay, cool.
The rebels are busy, you know, falling apart in their base.
Okay.
Well, I mean, those landowners aren't doing much better either.
So you're both landowners.
These band trashy trying to interfere.
The band trash is right here.
Yeah, the band trash. Everyone will align against you.
Ouch.
Uh-huh.
That pun was built into the game. I did not have to make that up.
It really was.
So which one of you is challenging the other?
Animated disagreement. Let's see.
So go up to setup right here.
All right, everyone plays. Decide who your chosen partner is. That would be the other rebel. That would be...
Ichiro.
Ichiro.
Not Ichiro. Ichiro.
Ichiro? Like Ichiro?
Yeah, very close to that.
It's bad translation. It's really bad.
I think maybe I'm arguing that just because she can beat me in foosball doesn't mean that she's a better...
No, I'm getting beaten in foosball. I'm losing.
Oh, you're getting beaten.
Yeah.
It's important that she's losing.
Everyone.
Okay, please. Okay. Maybe I'm explaining how my position is best for the most people. Ooh. Yeah? Okay.
So what is your position?
Yeah, what are you arguing over?
During the discussion, I guess details. That's a good question.
So we're rallying back and forth, and I've like slid over another point onto my.
I just gotten a mech from a night guard at one of the warehouses of the Benchrash warehouses, and we're arguing over whether I should keep it or whether it should be donated to the cause.
Okay, yeah.
And I think that like me, Arthur, and Michael, we're gonna play as the
yeah,
audience.
We're the audience.
Like the rest of the rebels that are there in base, like literally watching you argue over foosball.
Yeah.
I like the idea that whoever wins this also wins the foosball game at the same time.
Yeah, well, so
I'm definitely behind.
Yeah, I like. The
audience is going to be against me because they're not going to be like, oh yeah, you should keep it for yourself. Yeah, unless I can convince them to do that. Yeah.
What do you guys notice about each other, and what have you heard?
Where is this one? Conduct a chase. Oh wait, no, that's not it.
Audience, I'm looking at the wrong.
What do you note about?
It's from the solitaire.
Is like mentioning things from solitaire or anything different about like how you're dressed in this particular situation.
Maybe you noticed that I'm definitely like using rhetoric and like talking loud enough to try to like attract the crowd. And not just arguing with you.
You know, I'm going to seem kind of oblivious to what side the crowd is on. I'm just gonna, continue losing my foosball. It's like I don't know what this has to do with you and me and foosball and this this mech that I had just rightfully claimed. I mean, any one of it. Anyone could claim this thing. I mean, it was actually kind of easy.
All right. So now the audience conducts the discussion. Audience members take turns posing challenges to the position holders. The challenges are on page 13. You decide who goes. So we post a challenge, and then whoever posts the challenge decides who will answer first or let one of them volunteer. Once they've both answered, whoever asks the question awards one of them a coin, and they must decide. And if either position holder goes on too long, you can cut them off and award one point to their counterpoint, or just ask them politely to wrap up. And there's absolutely not allowed to interrupt or rebut one another. If either position holder interrupts the other or tries to get in a rebuttal, then cut them off at once and award a coin to the counterpart.
Okay,
I can't just say wrong.
Yeah,
no. Wrong.
That's correct.
The mic's not working.
Donald Trump would lose this game.
Yeah. Yes, he would.
Also, the coins from earlier can be removed because they don't carry.
Yep.
Wait, I lose all my coins?
The yes. Coins are just per game.
Coins are per game.
Wait, so we don't get to like stand on like a
no.
Tripod of winning?
Sorry. The tripod of winning is going to be who's alive at the end of the game, buddy.
Okay. That's a good
body. You stand on
prize.
And then at the end of three challenges, compare coins and whatever proportion of coins you hold, you can be confident that if forced to commit, the proportion of the audience, real or imaginary, would side with you based on that many coins. So I will start. This may be challenging for, so I'm going to ask you first, explain how your position of keeping the mech for yourself is best for the most people.
Hey, I clearly acquired this mech. It was pretty easy. I can put this to really good use. And if anyone can put this mech to a really good use, you should be able to claim it for yourself as well. If I let this guy take it, he's just going to wreck it. I mean, look at the mech he already has.
Virgil, counterpoint.
You can see that we have specialized pieces all across the board here. My goalie, he's wide, and he can block anything. However, if he wasn't equipped with the proper equipment, it would get right through, just like your sloppy scales.
Damn it.
We need to share the proper equipment with who needs it. If everyone's equipped, we can win this revolution.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to give my coin to Virgil here.
I'm going to give my coin to Ruby.
You got to ask a question first.
Oh, sorry. I thought we voted on. Is it you pick
it? No. You ask it. The person who asks the question.
Question asker gives it?
Yes.
Yeah, whoever asks the question gives the coin.
All right, very well.
You can ask a question and then assign a coin.
All right. I would like to go next and request that both of the players make a personal attack on their counter part.
Can I go first?
Oh, yes, please do.
Yeah.
The only reason you're still around is got your slimy hands on that mech that you can't even pilot properly. You can't even spin a foosball.
I think we should start rolling for foosball rolls, though.
Mini-game. Yeah,
1d2, If it's a 1, I'm still winning, but a 2, she's pulled ahead.
I know, Ruby. Why don't you tell me your personal attack?
I've seen the foosball table aboard on your mobile suit. It's insufficient.
Just calling your
that
shit.
Is that right. It? I don't know. I'm going to have to award this one to Ichiru. I really supported you in the first argument, but it was too brief. I didn't feel the heat.
I got nothing.
Personal attacks are hard.
Right?
I mean, for some people, yeah. For others, it's like dripping acid from your mouth. It's super easy.
Yeah. I mean,
you're a black dragon.
If you have empathy, maybe it's hard. Oh.
All right, Michael, you ask the final question.
I think an angry, like one of like the cook at the wherever you're hanging out stands up in the back.
Please explain how your position is urgent and unacceptable. Unprecedented.
Expedient.
I can do all of those things.
Why do we need to decide this now?
The reason is because mechs aren't lasting long in this war. I mean, I've gone through 3 mechs in the last 17 months, and that's because I'm in battle almost every single week.
But it's because you're shite. Casual heckling.
Yeah, I attempt to, like, whack the ball off the table at the heckler.
Nice.
Ruby, counterpoint?
I look over at the heckler, look at the ball. I look over to Ichiro, and I'll look over to the heckler and say, you know, I can see this argument. Here, I hand the heckler the keys to the mech.
All right. Great. I'll put up me spatula. The guy just like sets his stuff
have
down.
Fun with it.
Heads outside and totally gives the point to Ichiro because she just proved his point.
Okay, well, 100% of the audience is behind Ichiro.
You forgot the instruction manual.
That was because I'm so inspiring.
Excellent.
That was perfect. Good job, team.
If those Allie's game, so Virgil and Arthur, both of you have not done it yet.
That's true.
Okay, what else do we got? Oh, whoops, I scrolled up too high. I like the argument. We did a chase.
You can repeat games, by the way.
Yeah, you're probably going to have to. Just do them in different ways.
Can we know some more that there's a heckler out there with a
chef? Guard suit
that's... Yeah, there's like an Irish, maybe Scottish chef.
Stolen mobile frame.
With a stolen mobile frame.
I feel like
frame.
He gets a spin-off show that's a lot better than our show.
There's totally like a smash cut to a like bearded Scottish guy.
Hot like... cooking Gundam go!
Okay, I want to do meetings.
Instead of missiles? What are you doing?
Meeting. I want to do meeting sword to sword.
Oh. Who's your partner?
And I think I want to challenge the infamous Maximus Valentine.
Oh, I mean, you're in for a real treat then. Let's do this. How did we come to stand alone sword to sword?
Let's see here. What? Wait, where's the thing? Setup. Here we go.
Yes. I think maybe you were out on a routine patrol. I was also out on a routine patrol. And we engage, like, next to a lake. Any chance that we can be in our mobile frames?
Sure.
Perfect.
Sure. Okay. So what I notice about you is that I don't recognize your mech at all. So I don't know your capabilities.
New challenger has appeared.
Yeah.
My mech is big. It's like several times larger than yours. Clearly military model.
And I'm like, huh, I don't have any specs on my computer. I don't know any weak points. I'll have to tough this one out.
All right.
Scottish chef comes back in. He's compensating for something.
What have I heard about you, or what do I notice about you?
You probably noticed that I like have the sword is out already, like was out like from my arm when you first saw me. So it's probably broken like that.
Perfect, perfect. All right.
I would like to interject something that you guys have heard. Some crazy rainbow unicorn mech has intercepted and stolen supplies being sent by the Solar Union when they were in transit.
Oh, it's over. It's over now. Sorry. So my mech is approaching super fast with its quad engine lethal system. Both of my plasma cutters are out, and I'm broadcasting a hailing frequency like, this is Major Maximus Valentine of the Solar Union Unit Solar Angels. Revolutionary unnamed mobile frame, stand down immediately and prepare for peacekeeping forces to arrive. Majestically blowing inside my cockpit.
So, to get the duel, you ask a leading question on page 23.
Are the
okay? Was that an actual?
No. You asked the first leading question.
I asked the first leading.
I'm setting up me coming at you.
Can we establish the stakes here?
Begins.
Are the stakes your mech gets destroyed? Or are the stakes one of you die?
If you're in your mobile flames, being killed can mean the frame is destroyed, but you survived, or it can mean you're killed.
We'll see how it plays out narratively.
We have to decide.
If someone goes in the lake, they're fucking dead.
I feel like just having the frames get killed and not us would be a good outset. There's no reason to murder each other this early.
You hear over the comms back, you think you have fancy gear, but I have heart of iron! Ah! And I start running towards you. My mech falls and like starts rolling in the dirt, like looks uncontrolled. But then I slide right underneath you. I have my swords point to your clavicle. When I jump up, do you submit or do you twist away to rejoin the fight?
Oh, I twist away. So as your mobile frame comes in, I see your clear, like, there's no way anyone that unskilled could possibly make that mistake. And so as I'm hovering, I just, how do I describe this? If you've ever seen the Acquisitions Inc. Incorporated like web series, They always have gym dark magic hover behind everyone else. I feel like my mech never touches the ground, and so as you slide under me, I just rotate my mech and just hover out of range of your plasma cutter. Just far enough that it's no longer a threat to me. Now I get to ask a leading question. Perfect. So what is it? It's the
do we have to flip for this?
No, we go back and forth. We get three leading questions and then we do a closing.
I think. Ask leading questions, or after three, either one of you can ask one of the closing questions.
We circle sword tips touching. What do you say to me? So my mech's just hovering around you. I'm not engaging or approaching, but our plasma cutters are like. I'm keeping my left-handed one out of range just in case I need to, like, chop your arm off.
Okay. Is this answered by closing questions, or were you just...
No. You make up a question.
Okay, great.
Answer.
Yeah.
I want to know why you're here. So, you know, what do you say to me?
Yeah. I'm like,
you won't fight? Waiting for reinforcements, probably. Because you're a coward.
Oh... I don't need reinforcements. Look at your machine, little man. I think it's time to take your revolution and go home.
I catch your wrist in my hand and draw you close to me. I say,
the revolution needs no home. It's in my heart.
Do you let your sword drop, or do you shove me away and fight on?
Oh, I shove you away and fight on. You pull me in close, and I'm literally in my cockpit. I'm just like, what is happening here?
I'm like looking at you through your cockpit, like looking up at you.
I do the like arm thing where you just rotate your arms until like yours is getting ready to pop off, because my arms are so much more massive than yours, and I just float backwards. Let's see here. I can ask a closing question now, right?
Yeah.
Perfect. I get my sword point high up under your chin. Do you submit or flee? So, yeah, after I get back, I literally just plasma cutter right next to your face cockpit, and I'm like, unknown pilot, surrender immediately. Solar Union law will be quite lenient to you as my prisoner. If you don't want to meet the fate that you would at the hands of the band Treshi, you should come into my custody. I might have a use for you, son. You seem like you have some skills.
I probably have better chances with my secondhand parachute!
Doesn't even deploy?
I hope so. I mean, we have to roll dice, right?
No, there's no dice. Yeah. If you're fleeing... Yes. We've already established you're going to get away. I just love the idea that it doesn't deploy. You just land in the lake. I don't know who would ever say
that. I like it better that he thinks it's a secondhand parachute. But actually, when he pulls this deploy button, the head just pops off and rolls into the lake.
Perfect.
The head just like...
Blip. big bubbles.
Yeah. Perfect.
Excellent. All right. Well, Kelsa, it's time for me and you to meet, because I challenge you to a skirmish. Let's get tactical.
Ooh. Does that mean there's open war between...
There is. I would like to ask you, Kelsa, do you mind if other faction players join in here?
I would say maybe.
My intent is to ask every other player on the field to ally against the band trash and destroy them once and for all so that we can get back to the matter of who actually owns the land.
Oh, that's terrible.
Yeah. Knowing that, do you want to bring other players
definitely,
in?
Definitely do not. Only people that are invited may come, and I am going to put the kibosh on that.
This is the first, this is like the opening salvos of the open war between the landowners and the band trash.
Yeah, you did not get an invite to this war.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, tactical skirmish.
Can I come masquerading as a band trash?
No.
I'm driving a band trash mech.
The Scottish guy just rolls by, and there's just like towers of dust as his mech jets over the horizon.
I would like to put forward that my side is the attacker.
Totally.
How did this battle come about?
Let's see. Well, you obviously heard that I stole supplies. And I think that you set up like an ambush of another supply train. And when I led my squad over to capture it, your squad just pops out and the battle begins.
What you've heard about me is as I'm approaching, there's a news update of me on like the global news network announcing that we've begun open hostilities against the band Tresh because we found revolutionaries bearing arms provided by the band Treshy.
Is there like a video playing in the background that's like propaganda and it's actually of my mech being
your
like
mech.
Destroyed?
No, your mech isn't destroyed. We're taking it in and we're analyzing all the parts and we're noticing it's made entirely of band trashy.
Of course, it's band stolen band trashy.
It's band trashy is what it is.
So band trashy.
But we also uncovered like a truck full of band trash arms that had invoices sold directly to the revolutionaries, and we found just some random mobile frame pilot.
And there was like
stolen
four...
night mech who's just like a cook or something.
Some
he claims
crazy.
That he got it directly from the band Tresh. They just gave him the keys.
Yeah, he's just some random drunk.
That's proof of what you're claiming, like undeniable proof.
So we've come as peacekeeping forces to de-escalate the situation by removing the nobility's ability to keep this war going.
All right.
I'm leading 8 soldiers into the field because I have a massive unit.
So I'm leading 5 soldiers, which is not nearly as many. Still a fair number, but not as many. What you notice is that all of these mechs are like animal shapes.
Is one of them a bear?
No, that was from last time.
I know.
In the last game, I had a mech that was a bear. But they're all like 4-legged animals. So there's like a dog and a lion and like maybe a dragon. Got some wings or some shit on it.
It's a wyvern.
Yeah, wyvern. There you go. Dog, lion, wyvern, deer with like antlers and shit, and
and one duck. I mean, it has wings and two legs, but
and a duck. That
I mean, it doesn't have. Two arms, really.
A space ducky.
It's a space ducky. See, now you get your inside joke. So that's what you notice about my crew here. Both of us name our objectives in the skirmish. My objective is to steal the stuff and get away under your nose.
My objective is the complete disarmament of the band Treshy Noble Houses. Total war.
So are the stakes that she gets some random stuff and you just eliminate her faction entirely? Is that the stakes
of
here?
I mean, I feel like if she loses, there's definitely a chance she could continue playing as like a rogue band trash.
I was going to say, I don't think you can destroy the band trash entirely, but maybe wipe out House Roche.
Perfect. Sounds great for me. You're the agitators.
Slightly more reasonable.
Slightly more reasonable is my middle name.
Yeah.
Arthur slightly more reasonable Perkins.
Okay. Let's see. Take turns making demands of each other. The attacker makes the first demand. When you make a demand, you must choose whether to demand submission or withdrawal. In your demand, you must name yourself, one of your soldiers, or one of your enemy's declared objectives. So the skirmish ends when either one of you accedes to a demand, submitting or withdrawing. One of you loses their last soldier from your force, in which case you must immediately submit or withdraw, or one of you is killed or captured. So page 27 has all of the demands. What are you going to demand of me first?
So I feel like we have the thing that keeps happening with my mech, where I'm jetting across the countryside. That happens every time I show up. Mm-hmm. And it does the anime thing where it zooms into my cockpit and I'm leaning forward dramatically and my hair is waving and I'm like, Belle Roche, surrender now in the name of the Solar Union. Stand down and your forces won't be hurt. Submit, or my force spreads itself too thin and you pick off Halcyon, who is now straggling. So we're all like zooming at you really fast, but Halcyon is like going too fast and is way ahead of us and has exposed himself.
I will
place a Leroy Jenkins in the punch.
I will, yeah, I'm gonna cut him down.
Does he literally just run headlong into your unicorn horn?
That's pretty much exactly what I was gonna do. Okay. Except, like, I prance forward and just right through him.
And loving the word prance here. Really putting the
does your mech have, like, a
the visuals.
Yeah, it has, like, it's like really, of course it has a mane. It's like made out of like
carbon nanotubes or something like that.
Yeah, and it lights up. Like, my mech is not there. There's no way my mech can do stealth. It's like all chrome with lights and shit. It's crazy.
So my whole unit,
fiber optics and shit, like everywhere. Yeah, everywhere.
My whole unit is piloting Osprey V1s, so they look a lot like my mech, but about 25% smaller. And each of them has their own weapons loadout. And Halcyon is like a pole arm, and he's charging forward towards you. And I guess he just like gets tripped up and stabbed through in the chest. And he's like, "Boss, I'm sorry." Ah!
Yeah.
His cockpit explodes for no apparent reason.
They're rigged to explode in case there's like over 80% damage on the mech.
Yeah, of course.
For punishment.
They sure do. Withdraw now. So as we approach, Bella gets on the line and says, "Withdraw now. We don't need to fight. Sorry about your men. But too late." Or an opportune shot will cripple Kilbray in the dog mech, my lieutenant.
Oh, I mean, what's happening is one of the Ospreys is hanging back, and they all have jets like mine, but they're not nearly as powerful. And he's doing his best to stay just above the battlefield with a plasma rifle in sniper mode. And just for a second, the whole battlefield, like, everyone has cleared out of the way, and we follow the shot as it travels between the mechs, and it does that thing where a dust cloud,
like Killzone 2 trailer.
Yes, circular dust cloud is around it, and it keeps going closer and closer, and then your horn is, like, in the way for a second, and then it moves out, and it catches your lieutenant right in the cockpit and blasts him out.
Oh,
didn't need that lieutenant anyway.
I didn't. It's fine.
As
you all know, I mean, I care more about fashion than
practicality.
As we begin like full melee plus ranged engagement, our units are spreading out in a semicircle around each other, and just like lots of axing and. My mech is staying away from yours. I'm like wiping out the rest of your unit around you, or doing my best to do that. And I get on the comms and I'm like, "It doesn't have to be like this, House of Roche. Your actions in this war have agitated it. Everything has come about because of your greed. These people are citizens of the Solar Union. Submit now, or you're able to draw Cupid out of position and cut them down.
All right. As you say that, Bella gets on the comms again and says, "This is not about my greed. This is about my birthright." As the Wyvern mech goes around and draws out your men, cutting him down. And she says, "Your men will not, do not have to die here. Withdraw immediately, or what will happen here? Yolanda in the duck mech will, my least experienced soldier will submit to your surrender to your mercy."
I mean, I'm thinking surrender sounds very good right now to me. Okay. To me. Yeah. So you're calling for us to withdraw. And I literally take the duck mech and just like pick it up and start crushing it. And I'm just like, "Mobile frame pilot, eject now and I won't destroy you." Majestic hair swish.
Yep. a little duck boop.
Yep. And as they surrender, I put the mech down and yeah. I'm going to back down from submitting. I'm going to give you a chance to withdraw now. House Roche, you've clearly lost this fight. We have your soldiers. We have your mechs. It's time to back off. Withdraw now, or you're able to concentrate fire on Artemis and gun them down. And yeah, we're all like perfect V-wing formation through the center of your group. And just like taking your mechs and manhandling them because we're military.
So, at this point, Bella, the unicorn mech, like, main flip. And she says, "Full retreat. All soldiers, full retreat. House Roche will fight another day." And she says directly, like, you know, tight beam to Maximus and says,
"Of course.
I don't know where you got your intel, but you're wrong. We're on the same side of this fight. People didn't need to die today, but I will not forgive you." And then in a cloud of rainbow, it's gone.
And on tight beam still, I'm like, "You fired the first shot, Bantresh. Your position here is untenable. The Solar Union landowners own this land."
Drake's connection.
Is it the duck? I don't understand. Is the duck mech messaging me?
That was my bad impression of a dial tone as your type beam was out of range.
That sounds like the duck unit's alarm.
I'm just saying. It sounds like the duck mech is typing.
Turns out the duck unit is secretly jamming the communication, so you can't.
Oh, the duck was the jammer mech all along.
He was hidden in the second shuriken.
Yep.
That was the plan. You were going to get it destroyed and then it would just jam the rest of their tracking. It's perfect. Brilliant move, Kelsa.
Thank you.
Okay, yeah. So we've each taken a turn. We can now continue to take turns until someone gets tired and then we begin the end game. Is there anyone who would like to go again, or is there anyone that wants to end this?
I definitely want to go again, but the game I want to play is kind of long, so maybe somebody else should do another
break
game.
Break time, maybe? And you want to take a... What time is it? Oh, it's not quite 8.
I feel like we could get one
longer
more
than 15
game.
Minutes
yeah, yeah.
Before
so,
the break.
Yes. I want to hold a dance. And that is a longer
game. You can dance if you want to.
Victory over the forces of Maximilius.
Right.
Victory?
Yeah,
they left their mechs on the field and ran away.
It was a pure.
We lost
Maximilian, but
we lost Kilbrey and Yolanda is in custody. Mm-hmm. But
don't worry, we're not torturing her.
Yeah, let's do the dance. I want to see this.
Dance. It's going to be really long. Like, I feel like, as Kelsa says...
Where is it?
I mean, I want to invite everyone to this dance, yeah. And that's why it's going to take a long time. So, anybody else have a shorter game they'd like to get in first?
I do.
I'm going to do a chase.
I want to have... Oh, you're going to do a chase?
I'm like, Crystalline Bantrafil? What is this game? Oh, no, wait. That's not it.
That's what everybody's fighting over is Crystalline Bantrafil.
I'm chasing down Ruby.
Oh boy, Ruby.
I expect that she is the one that planted the bomb that I had to defuse earlier. And you also I think this is actually fairly obvious.
That's a crazy accusation.
There's like a rumor that's going around that the Yonkai are specifically here to maintain peace. Like, we are not supposed to get involved in open combat.
Let me understand your orders so far.
Over everyone, but
your orders are literally don't do anything, just be present.
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Okay.
That is my.
We're gonna provide a strong police presence in the area.
Think UN peacekeeping force in Rwanda.
I mean, they actually do stuff.
Yeah, I was gonna say that.
They weren't allowed to shoot. We're like not supposed to like actively engage in combat, and that's why we're a stealthy unit.
I mean, most ghost troops are not allowed to shoot unless they're being shot at already.
Yes. So I am in hot pursuit of Ruby. Let me just pull up the chains.
Ruby.
What page is the chase on?
It is on page 14.
Yep.
So, who's chasing who?
I believe you declared that you were chasing me.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So, who play? What do you know about each other? What have you heard? So, if you're chasing me, you would have, planting a bomb, you would have had some way of discovering my real identity. I wouldn't just plant a bomb as me. I would plant it probably with my unit.
Mm-hmm. I think you planted the bomb. You didn't have to.
Huh?
I think you did it. You don't have to.
Think I did?
Yes. That's okay. What I think. I'm making a bold-faced assumption. It's your call.
Okay.
As a player.
That
sounds like something Ruby would do, plant naive.
Plant bombs, yeah. But I would but the thing is that I would if I'm planting a bomb, I'm doing it probably disguised as the as AP's character. Or as his mech. Maximus's mech.
You're like holographing around are you like holographic yes. Projecting around yours so, his fucking mech?
So what if you are, so are you implying, and you can put the kibosh on this, but like, that he thinks he's chasing Maximum.
Yeah, I think.
If you're actually chasing me, you either discovered me or you think you're chasing someone else.
I actually like the idea that I'm, I like that idea that I think I'm chasing Maximus. Maybe I actually saw you trying to deploy an IED.
That is hilarious.
I mean, now you better catch her and clear my name.
I did that.
Sonny's just like, oh shit, no.
And you caught me planting this bomb, or you caught him planting this bomb in that foosball hall frequented by the rebels that you were ordered to not kill.
Why are you planting a bomb in your own base?
Who said I like them? I want to get my own.
Well, the rebel does specifically say that the rebels fight among themselves.
Apparently they're gonna murder each other.
That's cool.
Yeah, I mean I play foosball there like every Sunday and Wednesday, so
I also got a point to prove. I mean,
don't agree with me. Gonna kill all of you.
Okay,
and your families.
Oh, I'm not committing any crimes. It's that Solar Union guy. I mean, you see the way he does his hair. You can't trust him.
True. He's clearly the villain too. It's so obvious.
You do the... All right, so you do the challenges. You do the first two challenges, correct?
Let's see. So under conducting the chase...
No, the query does all of the challenges.
Right there.
Yeah. Yeah, the query does all the challenges.
She chooses every challenge, but the third one, there's four of them. The third one has to be an admission from the second section, unless one of the first two, it says that she doesn't have to.
Okay. Sounds good.
Okay. So
you can always pick an admission if you want.
I think we see you planting the bomb, and then just like half a mile away, the raven comes out of stealth and just like starts approaching, and you get like a hail calling for Maximus to answer the radio. And you feel free to take off at this point.
So I know this ground well. So the foosball hall, I'd imagine that's part of a larger encampment.
So it's like a small secret rebel held complex.
Yeah. So I know this ground well. Follow me if you dare, but throw. On tails, you're plunging into heedless danger, and I need not to choose any admissions during the chase after all. I am leading you right into the pile of other bombs that I rigged up on the flank of the encampment.
Just all the IEDs, okay.
And maybe I just want to be in like a background scene while you guys run like out of the foosball hall, and I'm like,
a question mark appears over your head. Boop.
I think we get the cut. I think we get like the anime style flashback of like Sami sitting in a bar and watching the skirmish that Maximus just took part in right before she gets accosted by a bunch of bantresh with like knives. And she's like, just this fucker. And then she guns her mech. And, maybe something happens, like, maybe it's like an industrial yard and like a crane starts to turn and she wasn't expecting it. And she like sidesteps into the IEDs that you planted earlier.
That's what we're flipping the coins for.
I rolled and I failed.
Oh, crap.
I rolled and I did badly.
I mean, it's great for you.
Yeah, you're doing good.
No concessions.
Okay. That probably fucks up your stealth ability. You probably need to get that repaired.
Oh yeah, the cloaking like comes off, and like there's like gray underpaint you can see through the stealth coating.
Okay. Totally. So coming out of the explosion, you see me on my way out of the encampment and into the woods. I press through a thorny briar. Follow me if you want, but throw. On tails, you're tangled and torn and must extract yourself, and I gain a coin.
So what I'm imagining here is it's...
Now it's maneuvering through the...
Riot-ass redwood trees, right?
Uh-huh.
And I think she like draws the katana and just gonna go machete on it if she can, or she's gonna miserably fail. And she does. What is up, Roll 20? She like goes to like cut, and maybe you like throw a tree back and it like impales into the mech's shoulder. Like has to like ride it.
Come on, man. I need you to at least turn that holograph field off.
I'm working on it. You don't have to give any concessions.
You're supposed to be my ally.
All right. Your turn again.
All right. So I get my coin. Let's see. And then... through the woods, I plunge through into the bogs in the stinking muddy water. Follow me if you want, but you'll need to ignore the stench and filth and ruin your clothing. Well, I didn't read that one through, but I'm sticking with it.
I think it's literally like an inland, like salt sea almost that we get to somehow. And I think as you like dive into it, I think she like stops and just looks at the water for a second and it's just like, no fucking way. No fucking way. This is, and she's like sitting in her mech, just like, no fucking way. This is him. This is not right. Fuck, I gotta go defuse a bomb. And then she turns around and goes back to the
that's a legit answer.
Yeah, she's just like, nope. Nope. All right. So the next scene is definitely gonna be her trying to repair her mech.
Yeah, the chase is over.
Oh, and I guess
you won. I gave up, so you won.
Total victory. He's breaking off to go defuse the bomb.
Yeah, so. I'm going to try fix the mess you created.
You mean the bomb that's about to go off in the foosball hall?
Yes, that's what I'm going to do.
Ah, damn it.
We gotta go defuse another bomb. Damn it. All right. Good job, team.
Well, this is a perfect time. Take a break. And when we be back, I'll continue to try to just crush Kelsa in any way possible.
Like at a dance?
I mean, shall we dance?
Whenever you're not busy trying to blow up foosball halls of some poor rebels, I mean...
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I mean, you know. Someone has to stop those dang rebels, but it clearly wasn't me, since I'm being recorded as being somewhere else fighting the band trash. Can a man be in two places at once? I don't know. We'll find out when we get back.
All right. See ya.